All right, so I'm for sure running late again today. This whole get up early every single morning for this and trying to pack for a whole day is, I haven't caught up to it yet, but we'll get there. I'm getting there. Dodgers play the Indians today. Some of the players are still sick. Ross Stripling was scratched from his start because he's sick, so I'm kind of assuming we'll still be missing a good chunk of players. Hopefully some of the ones that got sent home yesterday was more precautionary. We will see when we get there. I'm still hoping to get Seager. He's like my main guy that I want to get. And then after that, it's kind of just more basic autographs. Not basic, but people I've already got, so I can try to give away stuff on Twitter and just good pictures for people to see and all that stuff. So I should be at Camelback in about 15 minutes. Hopefully the line's not too long. I think this is about the same time I got there yesterday. So we'll see when we get there.
Need more than anyone. So I'm like heading in now. This is kind of the whole crazy process of all of it. They tell you not to run, but people always do, and it's like you get in line and then you get all the way up here and people run and then the line doesn't matter anymore. But during the week it's not bad. That's why you have little kids. You make them run, they get in less trouble.
Run, Tanner, run!
Got to get to that spot that Seager likes. I think he's in the lineup. I just looked at it really quick, but I ran in here, so I'm not sure. Well, actually, no, maybe not, because Taylor's shortstop today, I think. So, but that's where they'll come out of, in the dugout.
Yeah.
So hopefully we get some more autographs today. Morning, Matt. Morning, Matt.
All right, so autographs are done. It was actually a pretty good day. A lot of the players came out today. There's still, I believe, about 10 to 15 guys who are sick. It's kind of like Seager, Bellinger, Maeda, Hunjin, and Utley, I believe, were the big ones. But other than that, a few guys came out. I was actually lucky enough, let me get it out really quick, to get a couple. I was able to get one of my selfie signs. See, I take selfies with the players because it's better for them to sign. It's not something that they're worried you're gonna sell, but like here's Matt Beattie. He signed that one. And then I also got, this isn't a selfie, but let me see if I can, where to go? Oh. Here's another one. I got, where is it? Right there. Alex Verdugo, which I'm excited about because he's going to be really good. And then, so I have this blank Dodgers jersey that I bring for a lot of players that I just don't really have a ball they're expensive for. So I pick maybe one or two players I want on a ball, and that's kind of the only ball I'll get, and that's about it. So, but I got some good, pretty good ones today. Right here, we've got Rich Hill. That's Hunjin from the other day. And then right here, we've got Kyber Ruiz, who's going to be, he's a pretty damn good catcher, up and coming. Hang on, there's a B. Okay. And then this is Edwin Rios. I believe he's a first baseman. And then we have Will Smith, the catcher, and like the Fresh Prince. Different guy, though, of course. Duh. And then the last autograph I got today actually kind of comes from a funny story. If you follow me on Twitter, you might have seen my tweet yesterday where I had mentioned Walker Buehler hadn't really signed for anyone the last 3 days I'd been here, and he didn't seem to really want to talk much with the fans. And I wasn't sure if it was just because he's not the type of guy who's very, I mean, some of them it's harder for them to put themselves out there and be around fans. It's tough. Imagine, like, especially the younger guys, you come out of high school, college, and you've got people yelling at you nonstop. And so some of the players just need their space, and some of them love it. Some of them they usually get around to you is what I'm getting at. And Walker Buehler is one of those. So I put up on Twitter that I didn't really see him signing much and I didn't know why. And with the bug going around, I realized afterwards that could have been it. He may not have felt well. Totally understandable. But anyways, let me get back to the point. I put that tweet up and he saw my tweet. I didn't think he would. I didn't tag him. I don't like to bash players. I didn't want it to come off negatively. So I apologize about that. I know you won't see this, like you saw my tweet, but I did not mean for it to come off negatively towards him or any other player ever. So he actually came up to me and he's like, I saw your tweet. And I really didn't know which one he was talking about. And he's like, you know, the one where you said I don't sign for anyone. And I was like, no, I didn't, like, I didn't mean it negatively. I was just trying to, like, let other fans know what I've seen so far. And he's like, yeah, another fan called me socially awkward. He's like, I didn't like that. But he laughed. He was super, super cool about it. Like, he totally could have walked right past me. And I mean, I would have walked right past me. But he totally gave me the time of day, and I got him right here on the sweet spot. And so I'm super stoked about that because he's a hell of a pitcher. He's our number one prospect, and I'm really excited to see him up for the Dodgers this year. So that's a good little memory to have, and I'm just glad Buehler, he was a great sport about it. And that's really all you can ask from people who possibly probably do get berated on the internet every single day, intentionally, not even accidentally like myself. So I am here and I'm going to finish eating my food and then I'm going to head out to the game. So I will try and show you guys that, and we're going to be playing the Indians today. So hopefully the Dodgers can pull out a win today. All right, bye. Look around Camelback, but only to my seats because I'm a little late today. So I don't really want to walk around the whole stadium right now. There you go. Like, not many people here at all today. I think it's because it's the Indians. So it might be kind of nice that way. You can get a little bit closer. Socks on the other side, I think.
Pretty sure.
Oh yeah, see, there you go. That's where players come out. It's a clubhouse. That was Jock. Let me see, I'll go back really quick. Of course, now that I'm back, they're not going to come out anymore. But that was a couple of the starters from today's game. There you go, here's Tolles. Tolles is coming out. Stairs down there, that must be how they get there then. I think today I actually have actual seats. Yesterday I had lawn seats, but there was like less than 3,000 people there, so I just sat wherever I wanted. Oh, yep, see, look, there's Josh. They walk out underneath and then they come out right here. Bullpen. Try to go down there for a few minutes.
I'm down now.
Get out and play the Arizona outfield. Thank you.
Oh, is that an ambitious glove? Wait, is that a 44?
All right. I think most of the starters are already out on the field, so I'll try to head that way really quickly. Oh, this is like right where my seats will. A little bit more. My seats are like kind of behind the dugout, but I'm assuming I'm higher up. There's no way I'm down here. Definitely didn't pay for those. I'm a little late today, so I can't really get down there. I'll make sure to get here early for one of those games. So I can at least get down a little bit closer. Let's go see. I can walk down a little bit. This is where my seats are at, somewhere up there. The game, it's the top of the ninth, but it's a really long game, and the bottom of the seventh the Dodgers had scored, I believe it was five runs, and then the Indians put up six in the bottom or in the top of the eighth, and so game got dragged out a little bit longer than I would have liked, but they tied it up. Dodgers ended up blowing a big lead, and right now it's the top of the ninth and it's tied, but I have to head out. Gotta go pick up my mom and my dog. This game wasn't supposed to take this long. Anyways, so I got into the game, and like I said, I was going to my seat. Well, funny enough, I go to my seat, and the person that's there sitting in my actual seat that I paid for is Alana Rizzo. Like, she's sitting in my numbered seat, everything, and I walk up, and she asked me what's up as if like I went to look for her, because it looked like that. I walked right up to her, not even realizing it was a her first. And I told her, like, oh, nothing, you're in my seat. And she, like, went to get up, and I, of course, wasn't going to make her get up. And so she sat there, and I got to talk to her for a little bit. She was busy, so didn't want to bug her. She was keeping score. But I got to sit next to her for about three innings, which was cool, and just kind of see how she experiences the game, which is, as you'd expect, she's constantly updating the fans what's going on, Twitter, Instagram, and then doing her scorekeeping. So she had to leave after the third. I'm assuming she had to go set up for her interviews with the players and all that. Watched the game. Met up with some friends from Instagram. And I'm trying to think. I mean, the Dodgers did pretty well. The guys that gave up all the runs were our bullpen guys. Guys that might not be playing that much. But it wasn't too bad. It was fun. There was, like, nobody there. Which kind of surprising, but not that surprising because it's a Thursday. But anyways, I'm back out to my car now, and I'm gonna go pick up my mom and my dog from PetSmart, where they were hanging out for a little bit. And I don't know what else we're doing for the night. I'll figure it out, but probably gonna go sit at home and put together these videos and go through notifications and all that good stuff. But I know you guys don't care about that, so anyways, I don't think I will be coming out here early tomorrow because it's Friday and it's going to be a mess. And I haven't worked one day since I'm out here, so I'm thinking I might just go do Uber in the morning tomorrow. And I have to drop my mom off at the airport because she's going home. So you probably won't see anything from me here in the morning, but I am going to the game. And so other than that, I probably don't have much going on tomorrow, but we'll see. Heading over to the game. Gonna head home back to the hotel room now, rest for a little bit. Finally getting a little bit warmer out here in the 70s. But other than that, I may see you later tonight. If not, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Bye.